So, good day class. Today in our PCE 4 or Building System Design subject, we'll be discussing about the National Building Code of the Philippines. As we have discussed the last time we have our introduction, we'll be dealing with the codes and regulation existing in our country or in here in the Philippines. So first is the National Building Code of the Philippines. By the way, disclaimer lang, not all the codes or the rules or the articles on this code will be discussed here in class, and also it will just be a part one of our discussion when it comes to National Building Code, because there are a lot more to discuss when it comes to National Building Code of the Philippines. Then after that, we'll be discussing about the National Structural Code of the Philippines, because that is our specialization as civil engineers. So, and also in general, we are building structures today. So as you could observe, or in the social media or in the media, we are having our build projects with the administration today. So that's why it is at utmost importance that we are knowledgeable when it comes to our existing codes and regulation. First, we have the National Building Code of the Philippines. So it was approved called the Presidential Decree 1096 that was issued last February 19, 1977. So the last time that we have 1977 pa siya, meron na National Building Code of the Philippines. In short, it's been decades that we're practicing this code, if you will observe also, baka may nakakam sa inyo na we have the revised there's a years na nare-revise yung code, but the latest one is the 2018. But before that, we have memorandum series number 1 that has been issued by the Secretary of DPWH that time, that was in year 2005. So kung magkakaroon man tayo ng major the revision from 1977, that is on last 2005. So ito yung picture ng book, or itsura ng book na front page na makikita nyo. So mapapansin nyo dyan, doon sa may text ng new schedules and fees, that is the NBCDO Memorandum Circular Number 1 Series of 2005. That's why kung makakita kayo ng mga books ngayon, if you want to purchase yung mga books online or books sa mga bookstores, baka hindi ganito yung itsura yung makita nyo. Or baka ganito na rin, kasi ito na yung pinaka-latest edition But if you will have the 2005, yung medyo light blue, then 2010, meron din yon, then 2015, I guess, there's a 2015. Then, ito na yung latest, 2018. So, ano naman yan, nag-evolve yan, because of the additional contents that they add to the book. But as I've said, the National Building Code of the Philippines is downloadable on the DPWH website. Just go to dpwh.gov.ph, search there the National Building Code of the Philippines, or you could search on the Google search bar, that is just type National Building Code of the Philippines, then DPWH. Makikita niyo yung link doon. It's free, libre lang. So yung content niya, same pa rin naman yon sa kahit anong edition pang ilabas, because that's the yung pinaka-base niya noong 2005, yun yung nakalagay sa website ng DPWH. So ayan yung itsura ng National Building Code. So let's start with the, of course, sa National Building Code of the Philippines, ang kanyang nomenclature, yung pagpapangalan, is not article, it's about rules. So rule number 1 is about general provisions. Ano yung mga general provisions when it comes to the National Building Code of the Philippines? So section 102, section 101 di ko na sinama, because that is the title, which is the National Building Code of the Philippines, which is the Presidential Decree 1096. So ayun yon, declaration of policy na tayo sa section 102 na. It is hereby declared that to be the policy of the state to safeguard life, health, property, and public welfare consistent with the principles of sound environmental management and control. Of course, the number one reason of having this code is for us to be safe. Yun ang unang-una. Napansin niyo sa declaration of policy, safeguard life agad. Walang not to earn, not to have a profit, but to safeguard life. Yun agad ang kanyang concern. So to ayan, so and to this end, make it the purpose of the code to provide all building structures or any activities no ng requirements and regulations no. Kasi pag wala ng mga regulations no when it comes to building construction during that time no, we have called the tiger economy no. The Philippines is under a tiger economy. When we say tiger economy, progressing up until now, we're still a developing country, so kaya nga tayo mas maraming build projects eh, because we're not there yet as a developed country, we're still developing. So that's why the government no, with the help of the Senate and the Congress, passed now a law or a house bill, then it turns out to be the presidential decree that is known as the National Building Code of the Philippines. Yun yung reason for us to be yung regulated yung mga actions natin when it comes to building structures in particular no, kasi yun talaga ang ginagawa eh no, kasi mas madalas building structures. So and number one is to safeguard us from yung safety natin as a general public no, public welfare, kasi yun naman talaga pinaprotektahan ng state. So next is the general building requirements. What are the requirements no that building should have no in general? Ano yung mga dapat nating mapansin, dapat nating ma-observe no sa isang building or yung ginagawa pa lang? Number one is all buildings or structures as well as accessory facilities thereto shall conform in all respects to the principles of safe construction and must be suited to the purpose for which they are designed. So in short, kailangan ko ano yung purpose ng building, kung ano yung siyang ginawa, yun dapat ang i-serve niya. For example, that the purpose of the building is residential, it should be residential. If it is a manufacturing production site or a laboratory, it should be like that. No, kung ano yung purpose niya, yun dapat yung masunod. And also, meron siyang safe construction no, pag ginagawa. You know, kaya may mga safety officer tayo, nagsusuot ng mga safety equipment, di ba? PPE, protective equipment. So, ayun yung reason nun. No, kailangan mag-conform doon. Kailangan sumunod no sa safe construction and also to the purpose which is design. Next is buildings or structures intended to be used for the manufacture or production of any kind of product or article shall observe adequate environmental safeguards. Kung yung purpose naman ng isang building ay may kinalaman sa production site, of course there are ways, there should be proper sanitation, kailangan meron siyang environmental safeguards. When we say environmental safeguards, nag-conform siya sa number one sa Department of Environment Natural Resources. If that structure building will have chemicals as waste, diba? Kung magpo-produce siya ng mga chemical waste or waste, any waste for that matter, no? Yung mga sea waste water. So, kailangan nagko-conform doon. Also, papasok doon yung mga proper sanitation, diba? Kasi kaya may mga sanitary permit tayo, yung tinatawag, para hindi nga siya madumi or, alam yung conducive siya or medyo maayos naman tignan, no? When it comes to waste disposal. So, ayun yun. Kaya kailangan may environmental safeguard, proper or adequate environmental safeguard na ino-observe ang mga structure na mga ganun type. Next is buildings or structures and all parts thereof as well as facilities found therein shall be maintained in safe, sanitary, and good working condition. Ibig sabihin, kung yung building structure mo, halimbawa, nasa production site siya, for example, no, and you're making steel chairs, for example, you're making steel chairs. Of course, hindi mo pwedeng pagtabihin ang painting department at ang steelworks department, yung mga nag-welding, because we all know that paint are flammable material. So later on, kapag masyado na-expose sa high temperature, baka sumabaw, magka-cause pa ng fire and explosion. So kailangan meron ma-maintain yung safe, no, that's the number one. Sanitary, so when you say sanitary, may proper may water, 'di ba? May pwedeng paghugasan and all, no? And good working condition, maayos. Kung naka-office siya or dapat ang work niya is mag-design, of course, kung gagamit ang mga computer, we all know that the computer naghahangyan kapag exposed na masyadong mataas yung temperature sa paligid niya, kaya meron yan exhaust. So kailangan naka-air condition or the material itself, no? Kailangan nasa mababang temperature, halimbawa, no? So mga ganung bagay, kailangan ma-serve yun ng isang building or structure. So, kaya, yung mga authorities or the city itself, no, they are conducted yearly yung mga inspection, no, na ginagawa nila. So, ayan yon. Next is the definitions. No? Section 104 na tayo. When we say definition, these are the terms that we're going to encounter throughout this National Building Code. Some of the terms here, no, familiar na kayo. And some of the terms hindi ko na nilagay. Pero if you want to further read the book or the code, no, makikita nyo naman din na same din naman yan, yung definition na yan. No? Yung iba, hindi ko na nilagay kasi hindi na natin siya, hindi na siya kanon, ganun ka-importante for us, no, civil engineers or civil engineering student. So, number one is addition. Any new construction which increases the height and or floor area of existing building and structures. So, when we say addition, there's a existing building. Now, for example, it's a one-story residential building and you want to add a second floor. That is called addition. No, and that is classified as new construction. Of course, no, you will apply for a permit, working permit for that because it's another construction, no, new construction siya. So, ini-increase mo yung kanyang floor area, usable floor area. When we say usable floor area, so you will encounter I think you encounter that. No, pag sabi usable floor area, doon nakatira, yun yung ginagamit. So, and also in-increase mo yung height. Halimbawa, katulad ng binanggit ko kanina. So, you've increased it from one story to two story. So, you increase the height. So, that's what we call addition. Next is alteration. When we say alteration, the buildings, works in the buildings or structures involving changes in materials, use, partitioning, location, sizes, and openings of structural parts, existing utilities, and equipment, but does not increase, no, the building height and or floor area. For example, you have the kitchen. You will alter the kitchen na mas malaki. For example, from dirty kitchen, gagawin mo na siyang parang main kitchen mo na. Isasama mo na sa main kitchen mo. Halimbawa, no? That's what we call alteration. Babaguhin mo yung ibang parts, magsira ka ng partition, halimbawa, or mag-add ka ng partition, but you will not increase the area or the height of that portion of that building or the building itself. No? But from computer, ang building nyo is a computer shop. For example, one-story computer shop building, no, commercial building, naging computer shop. And you still use it as a commercial one. So, gagawin mo, imbes sa computer shop, magbibenta ka na lang ng mga computers. Same set, same area, no, tatanggalin mo lang yung mga, magbabago ka lang ng equipment, maglalagay ka ng mga storage box, no, because it will become a store na, hindi na siya computer shop, halimbawa lang. So, ganun, yun yung tatawag na alteration. Next is Office of the Building Official, so OBO. The office authorized to enforce the provision of the code, when you say code here, the National Building Code of the Philippines, and its IRR or implementing rules and regulation in the field as well as the enforcement and of orders and decisions made pursuant thereto. Sabihin, lahat ng nakalagay sa National Building Code, lahat ng kailangan ipatupad doon, lahat ng provisions and all, and even yung mga orders, memorandum orders galing sa secretary ng DPWH, because later on you will know that the secretary is the one appointing the building official. So, secretary of DPWH should be enforced, no, sa office of the building official. And the office of the building official is managed by the building official or BO, the executive officer of the OBO appointed by the secretary. Yung secretary dito is the secretary of DPWH. So, in this case, no, recent nating secretary is Secretary Mark Villar. So, siya nag-appoint ng building official natin in every city, no, or every municipality, no. So, ganun, kung merong or area of responsibility kung saan 'yun nasasakop niya. So, siya nag-appoint noon. Building permit. Now, when we say building permit, it's a document issued by the building official to the owner or applicant. So, kung ano ka, kung sino man nag-apply, kung owner ba siya, o ano ba siya, general contractor, kasi binigay na sa general contractor yung application. Of course, kapag general contractor, meron pa din, yung owner pa rin, kailangan pa rin ng kanyang signature to proceed with the construction. So, unless otherwise you have the building permit, nun pa lang kayo mag-i-start. No, kapag wala dapat work, there will be a work stoppage without the building permit. And that building permit is, ano, mayroon siya makasamang ano, documents to support that you could start. No, of course, the plans, the specifications, other pertinent documents like the TCT or transfer certificate title, and other supporting documents that are duly notarized. No, if of course this is a public transaction and all of building permit is a public document. So, kailangan siya manotarize yung supporting documents. So, ayun yun, and if the application is found substantial and satisfactory, then, with the National Building Code, then the building official will issue a building permit. So, building permit, by the way, is not a right. No, parang hindi pwede, hindi karapatan ko magkaroon ng building permit. No, it's a privilege. No, when you're having a building permit, that's a privilege. Pwedeng bawiin yan sa'yo anytime. If you have grounds para bawiin sa'yo yung building permit mo. So, ayun yun, no? Yun yung building permit. Next is construction. What is a construction? It's an activity. All on-site work done in the site, no? Pwede preparation, no? Abawa, nagkagawa kayo ng temporary facility. That's called construction. Excavation, kapag nagawa kayo na foundation, gumagawa ng pundasyon na. And all components and installation of utilities, machineries, and equipments on the buildings or structure. Lahat, no? Any activity na ginagawa sa site is what we call construction. No, kaya pag kaya nga iba tao, oh, yun na yan, may construction na dyan. So, dahil yun naman talaga ang tawag doon, no? So, yun. Any activity na ginagawa sa site. Of course, before the construction, you have the building permit. Yan. Next is conversion. Ano pag sinabing conversion? A change in the use or occupancy of building, structure, or any portions thereof which has different requirements. It is not the same, no? Kanina we've defined alteration. When we say alteration, same area, no? Wala kang dadagdag na space. Then, same yung function. Halimbawa, kitchen, you will combine the dirty kitchen with the main kitchen. Still, it's a kitchen in general. But when you say conversion, you will change the use or occupancy of the building or structure. For example, from a commercial building, you will convert it to residential. Halimbawa, computer shop, yung binanggit ko kanina. Then you've realized na, mahirap na mag, ng computer shop ngayon because of the pandemic and all, no? You have fears and all. No? You've assessed that magkakaroon ng mababang ROI or no ROI at all, malulugi. So you just, live with it, no? Naging residential na lang siya. That's what we call conversion. So, magbabago ka ng space, diba? Ibahin mo kanyang use. Of course, you will declare that to the city engineering office, and the city engineering office will also declare that with the building official, or you will apply that for another building permit because magpapalit ka ng occupancy, no, ng type of occupancy. So ayun yon, no, yun yung tatawag natin na conversion. Next is demolition. Ano ba yung demolition? It's a systematic dismantling or destruction. So kapag magde-demolish ka, no, it's a systematic, not just okay, sirain na yan. No, the building will be destructed or will be demolished. Number one, kapag there will be an analysis, no, na ginawa ng mga engineers. Of course, those are the structural engineers. Kung sino-sino yung mga consultant, no? Most of the time, hindi lang isang consultant ng mga dinedemolish na building, no? Minsan dalawa, minsan tatlo, no? Because number one, there will be insurances na nakataya diyan. So kapag dinedemolish ang building, may insurance, no? Kaya nga minsan kapag nasunog, 'di ba? For example, hindi sinasadya. So, may insurance yan. That's why, kapag dinedemolish yan, mayroong insurance. That's why, there will be consultants, no? Tatanungin, okay, is this building recommended to demolish? So, they will assess the building. No, if they found out na yung structural integrity niya ay sobrang baba na to the point na any moment babagsak na yung building kapag may tumira doon or may gumamit nun, then, that's the right time that they will recommend that to the building official. They will recommend that to the city engineering office, or to the district engineer or the regional director DPWH, then demolish that building. No, yun yun. Systematic dismantling. Hindi basta-basta magda-demolish, no, ng isang structure or isang building. So, ayun yun. Next is renovation. Pag sinabi renovation, any physical changes that you made on the building or structure to increase the value or quality or to improve the aesthetic. So, just kaiba sa conversion, no? Kasi conversion, babaguhin mo talaga eh. Or alteration. Alteration, pwede mo siya mag-under ka ng renovation because you renovate something. You increase the value unless, diba, nagdagdag ka. Pag sinabi ko renovation, you're increasing the value of that property or that building. No? Kasi binavaluate yan. Tapos binavaluate yung yearly, no? May nagpapadala yung mga banks. No? For example, that building will be ipapa-auction siya. So, kailangan i-evaluate na siya ng mga real estate no evaluators no. Ayun, so i-evaluate yung property. So first you have to renovate para tumaas yung value niya. No, and to improve aesthetics as well para maging, of course, kung ibebenta mo siya, kailangan medyo maganda yung itsura niya, 'di ba? Papapinturahan mo ulit, papaayos mo yung roofing and all. So ayun yung renovation. So ayan, so repair. No, next, repair. Any remedial work done on any damage or deteriorated portion, buildings or structure to restore its original form. Pag sabi repair, of course, no, if may nasira, bawa, you want to repair the roofing. No, para ba ginagawang repair sa roofing, no, kapag may mga butas, of course, they will put it a sealant, they will paint it, repaint. Kapag mga stairs, bawa, may mga sira na papalitan, no, or nalagyan na sealant, then repaint ulit, no? So there are a lot of methods in repairing certain parts of the structure. So ginagawa yon so that it will at least restore to its original condition. Of course, the strength of materials will not be the same, but this aesthetically or yun, kung nagtitipid, no, i-repair mo siya. Kung gusto mong palitan, that is ano na siya, renovation na siya. No, papalitan mo na eh, papagandahin mo na. Of course, that will increase the value of the building or the property. So, ayun yun. Punta tayo sa rule 2. Meron pang mga kasama yung sa rule 1, no, hindi ko na nilagay. Nasa sa inyo na yun, no, to read more about that, no. But I just discussed the, yung kung ano lang importante about the rule 1 ng NBCP or the National Building Code of the Philippines. So, pass na tayo sa rule 2, which is the administration and enforcement. Under sa administration enforcement, meron pa yung section 201, 202, and so on and so forth. Pero talo na tayo sa section 205, which is building official. Ano ba yun? Definition ng building official. Or sino ba ang mga building official? Except otherwise, as otherwise provided herein, the building official shall be responsible for carrying out the provisions of the code. The code here na pinapertain is the National Building Code of the Philippines, as well as the enforcement of orders decision made pursuant thereto. So lahat, no, as I've said earlier, any orders, no, aside from the code, no, the code itself, of course, they should be enforcing that, no, to the public. But if there are memorandum orders, there are circular orders, no, or issuance of yung mga laws na pinapatupad, no, so they should enforce it in relation to the National Building Code of the Philippines. Dahil that's their job, no, that's what they do, no, that's the building official. And all building officials are appointed and designated other than by the secretary as defined kanina sa ating definition. Shall continue to act as building official if there's a existing building official. That building official should maintain as the building official unless otherwise the secretary appoints another building official. So, halimbawa, no, before Secretary Mark Villar became the secretary of DPWH, there are existing building officials. No, if during that time, the Secretary Mark Villar, no, inassume niya na yung kanyang post, no, he has the right to appoint another building official. No, of course, may mga qualification yan, mamaya discuss natin. But if Secretary Mark Villar, no, didn't change the building official on a certain area, no, that building official will remain as the building official. So, pero kapag meron siyang gustong ipalit, no, may karapatan siya because that's the duty of the secretary to appoint a building official on a certain area, no, ng isang city or municipality. So, ayun yun. Offices of the building officials already established, separate and distinct from the office of the city municipal engineers in cities, and municipalities may continue to exist until such time that a regular office is created. So, kapag may office na, for example lang ha, the office of the building official of Manila, halimbawa lang, ay nasa loob pala ng City Library ng Manila. If nakahanap na, nakagawa na ng certain office of the building official sa loob ng City Hall ng Manila, that means that it will be the office of the building official. So, kung nag-rent sila sa labas, then that's the office of the building official. Kung ano yung ma-approve, no, of course, with the city, with the DPWH, so, ayun yun. No, doon mapupunta yung kanilang office, yung kanilang regular office. So, eto, makikita nyo, pamapansin nyo dito yung kanilang structure, organizational structure. So, from the top, building official. Then, under niya, meron siyang assistant. The assistant building official ay siya na namimili noon, yung building official. Pwede mag-recommend ang Secretary of DPWH depending on the qualifications, of course, no, if that's a vacant position, so there will be qualified applicants. So from there, pipili yung ating building official or recommendation from the Secretary of DPWH. Then yes, the cashier. Now, of course, may mga binabayaran niyan. The building permit, the fines, no, and the fees that we have, no. And we have the administration and legal. Kapag may mga legal matters na kailangan i-asikasuhin ang Office of the Building Official, yes, a legal team. So, dalawa yan, no. Meron tayong tinatawag na Processing and Evaluation Division. And we have the Inspection and Enforcement Division. So, dalawa. So, Processing and Evaluation Division. Ito yung before and during applying the building permit. No, ito yan, sila yan, no? May pang mechanical, may pang architectural, of course, may pang civil structural, may pang mga land zoning, kapag alam natin yan, kapag pwede ba itong tirahan or under ba ito, pwede ba siya maging residential and all, ayan, sanitary, plumbing, and so on. Lahat na may kinalaman doon, no, sa application ng building permit. Of course, there's also counterpart people, same, no, may civil, structural, architectural, plumbing, sanitary, electronics, sa inspection and enforcement. Ito naman, sila naman yung nag-inspect. Mababa, ano na, naka 60% na, you declare on the report, may nag-inspect na, sabi nyo, 60% na yung construction, or may makakita, no, nag-inspect sila, kung sumusunod ba sa mga nilagay ninyo sa, in-apply nyo for the building permit, then, sila yon. No, sila yung mag-evaluate, no, mag-inspect sila, enforce nila if you're not having the right PPE. Halimbawa, you will warn that okay, all the people that you have there should be wearing proper PPE. Yan. So, ayun yun. Next, section 206 is the qualifications of building official. Ano ba yung mga qualification ng building official para siya magiging building official? Number one is no person shall be appointed as building official unless he possesses the following qualification. Number one is a Filipino citizen and of good moral character. Of course, you have to be a Filipino. Paano ka ba magiging Filipino citizen? Number one, you are born in the Philippines. Kahit foreigner ang mga parents mo, basta pinanganak sa Pilipinas, you're a Filipino. Number two, if your parents are both Filipino and you are born here, you're a Filipino citizen. If you're not born here in the Philippines and you are born abroad, but your parents are 100% Filipino, both, then you are a Filipino. So, yun yun. Number one, dapat Filipino ka talaga. And of good moral character. Of course, the position will be in the government. So, dapat, no, wala kang criminal record. No, I mean, malinis yung pangalan mo and all. So, yun yung number one qualification. Number two, a duly registered architect or civil engineer. So, sir, the question is, bakit duly registered architect or civil engineer lang ang pwede maging building official? The answer to that is maybe. Ito, I'm not answering specifically, this is the main reason, ha? I'm just answering it based on my observation. Architect knows in general the construction. I mean yung general knowledge, halimbawa the design, diba? They knows it. Because most of the time, architects are the one producing the plans first. No, the architectural plans. Then, saka pumapasok yung structural. Then, from structural, bumabalik yun sa architect, no, to check when if the design of the architect is good or not, depending on the structural analysis of the civil engineer. So, ideally, architect and civil engineer should always be in good terms. No, yun dapat. Kasi sila yung nagpapalitan talaga ng most of the ideas because may kinalaman sa aesthetics, number one, then structural integrity. So, bakit nga, balik tayo sa question, bakit architect or civil engineer lang ang pwede? Yun nga, they have, both of them have general knowledge, but not being biased, but civil engineers, most of the time, are the ones responsible when it comes to building construction. Of course, that is because of the structural integrity. No? Kasi, let's admit it or not, no? Or kahit ayaw man natin aminin, ang mga architect, hindi nila alam mag-compute ng mga, bawa, stresses sa mga beams. No, of course, some of you here, I think you are taking up strength of materials or you just finished your statics of rigid body. So, wala pa kayo sa mga higher subjects like steel design, no, I don't know. Or mga reinforced concrete design, sa mga higher years pa yon. But, we civil engineers, no, tayo, are dealing with that most of our course outline natin, no, yung ating course as civil engineering. Then the board exam yung pa rin ang hina-highlight. So kaya mas mataas talaga yung chance na mapili tayo as building official, no. Also with the architect, no, with I respect them, no, kasi I have also naman mga friends na architect, no. We are in good terms, to be honest. But most of the time, no, civil engineer lagi ang na-front when it comes to structural integrity, not the architect. No, architect aesthetics, yes, and some of the design, but not most of the time. No, so ayun yon. Kaya if you're going to visit our office of the building official, don't be shocked or parang may magulat na, oh, bakit architect siya? Ba't hindi civil engineer? Kasi pwede namang architect, no? Or most of the time naman, civil engineer talaga ang nagiging building official. So, ayun yung pangalawang qualification. Next is a member of good standing of a duly accredited organization of his profession of not less than 5 years. No? Sa civil engineering, so ang accredited organization natin is the Philippine Institute of Civil Engineers. Sa mga architect naman is the UAP or UAP is the United Architects of the Philippines. So, kailangan meron silang at least 5 years of membership na may good standing. So, and meron silang tatawag na peer recommendation. No, kailangan nila yon, no, from the organization. That because, paano magiging, if the Secretary of DPWH will choose a building official, of course, may advantage kapag meron kang papers na pinahawakan na, okay, this is a peer evaluation or peer recommendation, no, from this organization that states that this person is a duly member of that organization and with good standing. So, at least, diba, medyo mabivito ka ng mga kasama mo. Mga pa, ano tawag dito? Kumbaga, maano ka nila, sagot ka nila, diba? Parang ganun ang dating, no, sa itang banbal. No? Sagot ka nila because they can testify that you are qualified to that position. So, yun yung number 3. Number 4 has at least 5 years of diversified and professional experience in building, design, and construction. 5 years, no, why? Kasi at least minimum 'yon, no. Dahil nga kapag gumraduate, halimbawa, no, nag-take tayo ng board exam, for example, kaya mag-take tayo ng board exam, then tapos na, naging engineer na kayo. At first year naman, hindi naman kayo mapupunta agad sa iba't ibang field unless patalon-talon kayo ng work, no. Pero of course that will affect also your standing, no, sa career ninyo. And kaya siya at least 5 years kasi most of the time, no, ang isang project nagtatagal ng 2 years or 1 year. So, kaya 5 years ang ano kasi diversified. Pag sinabi din diversified, not just on project management, not just on estimates, kung napunta ka sa quantity survey department, no, or not just on the design, no, lahat, lahat talaga. And not just in building construction in general, no. Also, if mag-apply ka for DPWH, no, laging tanong dyan, may alam ka ba sa horizontal structure. Now, when you say horizontal structure, yung mga roads, di ba? Also, yung mga dams, di ba? So, lahat yan, no, may kinalaman yan sa pag sinasabing diversified and professional experience, no? Kaya, yun yung isa sa mga requirement. And, last, has attended and successfully completed a seminar workshop on the Presidential Decree 1096 and its IRR conducted by the DPWH. So, kung may mga applicants na, of course, they will announce that there will be a seminar or workshop, no, sa DPWH, lahat ng mga applicants. From there, saka na makikita ng secretary ng DPWH na, okay, qualified to. So, ganun yun, no, hindi basta-basta pinipili na ng building official, he or she has the qualification first, no, lalo na yung, ano niya, yung kanyang capacity to lead a certain office, which is a government office, no, that is very important and crucial, no, sa mga projects ng ating government. So, yon. Next is a section 207, which is the duties of the building official. Ay, ano ba yung mga trabaho ng building official? Number 1, primary responsible enforcing the provisions of the code. So, just like I said, no, pangatlo na siguro to. Lahat ng may kinalaman sa National Building Code, he or she should enforce it if he or she is the building official. So, lahat ng yan, every action that is going to take, no, naka-align yan sa kanyang sa National Building Code and also with the directives from the Secretary of DPWH, no, kasi siya naman ang nag-appoint sa kanila. So next is have overall administrative control and supervision of all works pertinent to building structures in his area of responsibility. So, lahat, no? Even the district engineers, the under sa kanya yung mga city engineers, diba? So, of course, he has to check those people, no? Kung kailangan niya magpatawag ng meeting, no? To assess them. So, kailangan niyang gawin yon. And supervision sa mga ginagawang building structure, not just yung mga permits, no? Kailangan niya yan i-check every time, no? Yung mga ini-issue niya because pirma niya naman yung nakalagay doon. That's why he has to check it, no? May administrative control siya and regulation or supervision sa mga bagay na yon. Next is ensure that all changes, modification, and alteration in the design plans during construction phase shall not start until the modified design plan has been evaluated and the desired amendatory permit issued. Sabihin, if nagpalit ka, halimbawa, from commercial, midway you want it to become residential, then you will apply again for another permit which is called amendatory permit. You amend, no? Mag-appeal ka na, okay, we're not going to use it as a commercial anymore. We will continue it as a residential. Then, file another papers, file another permit for that, which is amendatory permit. No, kailangan close doon yung ating building official because sometimes doon na-abuse. No, ang application is residential, then it turns out to be a commercial. So, kailangan specified yon sa kanilang building permit. No, because there are corresponding taxes and fees when it comes to that. No. So, next is undertake annual inspections of all building structures and keep an up-to-date record of their status. So, kapag may, of course, we have the, as I've discussed kanina sa kanilang organizational structure, they have the inspection and yun yung enforcement division. So, that division will inspect, no? Kung ano yung mga update na mga structure or building, no? Kung kailangan na bang i-demolish, kailangan ba siyang i-repair based on their check, or ano ba, yung safety ba ng tao, okay pa ba? So, lahat ng yon. No, kailangan niya magkaroon ng annual inspection. Yung minsan nga twice a year pa yan inspection na yan if the building official insists, no, to his division. But minimum annual, no, kailangan. Of course, yearly kailangan mo talaga tignan kung maayos pa yung mga building structures mo. Next is upon complaint or motu proprio, if there are complainants, after due notice, kapag na ano na na pag-aralan na, there are hearings, initiate action towards number 1, issuance, non-issuance or suspension or revocation or invalidation of the building permit. So, sabi ko kanina, building permit is not a right, it's a privilege. Now, if found that there are the complaint is legitimate, so I mean totoo siya, true, and there are enough evidences, then the building official will have the non-issuance or suspend your building permit or revocate, no, yung inyong mga building permit. Then kung may na-hear na, issuance of work stoppage order. For example, it found out that you're not having the proper PPE or yung safety ng mga tao nyo is not safe, no? Hindi talaga safe. So, kapag mayroong enough evidence the filed in the office of the building official, then there will be work stoppage. Napapatigil yan. Then, of course, there will be fines and fees corresponding to those actions. So, yun yun. Next is declaration of a building structure as ruinous or dangerous. If that building found out na, okay, ano na to, sirain na lang kasi mapapahamak pa yung mga tao. So, ayun. Kaya kailangan nila ng annual inspection. That's why there are also consultants that the building official needs. No? Meron siyang administration and legal kasi may mga legal processes yun. No? So, kapag nakita na wala na talaga, no, mataas na yung danger, so, sirain na lang, demolish na lang. Next is the imposition of appropriate fines, no, and penalties. Of course, kapag nag-violate ka naman, no, you have to fine, no, with a certain amount, no. Ayan yung sa 2005 edition, no, they declare a certain fine. Of course, nag-increase na yan sa ibang cities and municipalities depending on their sangguniang panlunsod or yung kanilang council, city council, government council, regional council. So sila yon with the help of their governor, mayors. So ayan, they have the fines. Also, ina-approve naman din yan ng building official and the DPWH, no? Sila kasi ang final authority niyan. Inire-recommend yan sa kanila. So next is the submit quarterly situational report to the secretary through the NBCDO or National Building Code Development Office on the status of all existing, ongoing, and proposed public as well as private building structures or activities. So, kailangan niya mag-report quarterly sa Secretary of DPWH. Why? Because those reports as well will be forwarded naman to the President of the Philippines during cabinet meeting. No, kaya kailangan talaga ng mag-report ng ating mga building official. Not just on the public, no, public projects, but also with the private ones. No, lalo lang here, we have the PPP, no, the Public-Private Partnership projects, no, yan, Skyway, yung mga PNR, yung mga trains natin ngayon na ginagawa, railroads. So, lahat yan ay under PPP or Public-Private Partnership. Kaya yan, no, kung ano yung area of responsibility ng building official, of course, that building official should report to that Secretary of DPWH, no, quarterly, no, minsan nga ano pa yan, monthly pa yan, no, if the Secretary of DPWH demands for it, no. So ayun yon, yun yung kanilang work. Ito yung ano, makikita niyo yung communication flow, no, ng kanilang quarterly report. Ayan, from administration and legal, so papasok, no, yung mga documents, then to the building official, then papacheck niya yan, no, sa processing and sa dalawang division na meron siya, the processing and evaluation, tapos meron siya sa inspection and enforcement. Kapag okay na, so punta sa mga district engineer, ipapacheck sa kanila, then sa regional director, then babalik sa kanila ulit yan, then pasa niya sa NBCDO to the secretary. Tapos kapag okay na, if there are revisions, if there are complaints, if there are concerns of the secretary, bababa ulit yan, babalik ulit sa building official. Then if there are issuances of memorandum orders or any guidelines, to i-out din yan sa through administration and legal, na public document naman yan. So ayun yung kanilang flow. Masalimut siya in such a way that it has to be that way, no, para magkaroon tayo ng check and balance. So ayun yon. Then last, I think this is the last, undertakes such other duties and tasks as may be assigned by the secretary from time to time. Yun yung sinasabi ko na if the secretary wants it to be monthly report, then the building official should report monthly to him or to her, no. So kasi yun yung ano niya, yun yung because lalo na ngayon na we are always a developing country, that's why we need those reports, we need those paperworks, no. It may be sound na parang hindi naman engineering yan, eh, no. Those paperworks will be the proof that you have finished something, you have done something. That's why the building official should report, no, to the secretary from time to time, no. Or kung may pinapagawa ang secretary through memorandum order, then the building official should enforce it also. So I think that's the end of our discussion with regards to National Building Code of the Philippines. That's only part 1. If you have questions, if you have concerns, hopefully you've learned something, no, from our discussion, then just message me. If that question or concern should be addressed in a class, no, I will answer that in a class setting or through group chat. So, thank you for your time, and hopefully, you've learned something and next you to our next meeting or class.